A very good morning to you all, Click. This is the fourth chapter of your SST, and in this chapter, we are going to know something more about the plateau and the desert regions. In this video, we will start with the plateaus. The plateau region of India. Let us first know what the plateau is. Plateau ka definition, aap log apne previous class mein bhi pad chuke hain, and in previous chapters also, you have learned the plateau. But let us recall the plateau. It is an area of flat land. एक flat land area होता है which is higher than the land around it, जो अपने आस पास के land से raised होता है, थोड़ा उठा हुआ होता है, and that is why it is also called the table land. Okay? Plateau is also called the table land. Plateau region जो है वो India का that extends from the south of the northern plains. Northern plains के south से शुरू होता हुआ it goes to the southern tip of India. ये जो India का southern tip है, यहाँ तक ये plateau region जाता है, and there are so many hills and the ranges are there in this. The Aravali range you can see, the Raj Mahal hills are here, the Vindhya range. So several hill ranges are there in this plateau region, and the Eastern Ghats. These are the Eastern Ghats and the Western Ghats. You can see here, this one. So they covers so many area, such a vast area it covers, and the states जो ये cover करता है, they are the Gujarat, Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra, Jharkhand also. We are living here. This is the Chota Nagpur Plateau. We are living here only. Okay. Then Chhattisgarh, Odisha, Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, and the eastern parts of Kerala also lies in this region. The river Narmada. जो नर्मदा रिवर है दैट डिवाइड्स द प्लेट्यू रीजन इनटू टू पार्ट्स. नर्मदा रिवर इस प्लेट्यू रीजन को दो पार्ट में डिवाइड कर देती है. यू कैन सी रिवर नर्मदा फ्लोइंग हियर. यहाँ रिवर नर्मदा है, ये डिवाइड कर देती हैं प्लेट्यू रीजन को दो पार्ट्स में. द लेट अस फर्स्ट इरेज दीज एक्स्ट्रा लाइन्स फ्रॉम हियर. ओके, these two parts, ये river नर्मदा यहाँ है, and then ये दो part में divide कर देती हैं इस plateau region को. the central highlands that is here, okay, and then the Deccan, okay, the Deccan plateau in the south. ये central highland है और ये Deccan plateau. first let us see the central highland, okay. The central highland include the Malwa Plateau. You can see here, this is the Malwa Plateau in the central India, and the Chota Nagpur Plateau is here, जहाँ हम लोग हैं, and in the rivers Chambal, Betwa, Son River, they all originate here, and they flow northwards. Okay, ये जो rivers हैं ये northward flow करती हैं to join the river Ganga and the Yamuna here in this Indo-Gangetic plain. Okay, and then these rivers begin in the Narmada and Tapi, that begin in the Vindhyachal range, and they flow westward into the Arabian Sea. You can see the Arabian Sea here. ये westward flow करती हैं और Arabian Sea को join कर लेती हैं. Malwa Plateau. This is the Malwa Plateau which we have just seen in this region. This is bounded by the Aravali Hills. ये Aravali Hills हैं इसके north west में, and the Vindhyas in the south. और ये Vindhya range यहाँ आप देख रहे हैं इसके south में, and it has a very fine black soil. यहाँ बहुत ही अच्छा black soil मिलता है, and that is very good for growing the crops and the oil seeds also. और जो छोटा नागपुर plateau है, ये जो हमारा region है, और आप लोग ऐसे भी जानते होंगे, it's very rich in the deposits of coal, iron ore, manganese, bauxite, mica, and other minerals. Okay, so this range, this one, the Aravali range and the Vindhya range, it has very good soil, the black soil for crops and oil seeds. और ये जो छोटा नागपुर plateau है, it's very good deposit of minerals. So this is, we were talking about the central highlands, this area. Okay, we are talking about the central highland only. Now let us see the Deccan plateau, this one. the region south of the Narmada river. Okay, we have seen the river Narmada flowing over here. So the region that is the south of the Narmada river and the Satpura range also, that comprises the Deccan Plateau, and the Deccan Plateau is the largest plateau in India. Okay, and this plateau is bounded by the Western Ghats and the Eastern Ghats. You can see the Western Ghats and the Eastern Ghats here. So this plateau is bounded by these. The Western Ghats are a long range of hills, and they include the Nilgiris, the Annamalai Hills, and the Cardamom Hills. Here is the Cardamom Hill also. Okay, here are the Cardamom Hills. So the Eastern Hills, they are not as continuous as the Western Ghats. यहाँ जो ये वेस्टर्न घाट्स हैं, दे आर द कॉन्टिन्यूअस वंस. ये पूरा का पूरा हिल रेंज है. एंड द ईस्टर्न घाट्स, दे आर नॉट एज कॉन्टिन्यूअस एज द वेस्टर्न घाट्स. यहाँ बहुत छोटे छोटे हिल रेंजेस हैं. देन द रिवर्स, रिवर्स दैट फ्लो इन द दक्कन प्लेट्यू. द रिवर्स ऑफ द साउथ, दे आर फेड बाई रेन. ठीक है, बारिश के से ही ये रिवर्स में पानी होता है. एंड दे आर नॉट द पेरिनियल रिवर्स. पेरिनियल रिवर्स वो होती है जिनमें थ्रू आउट द ईयर पानी सफिशियंट फ्लो करता है. सो द रिवर्स इन द साउथ इन दिस रीजन, दे आर नॉट द पेरिनियल वंस. दे आर फ्लडेड विद वॉटर ड्यूरिंग द रेनी सीजन एंड समटाइम्स आफ्टर दैट ऑल्सो. And the most of the rivers, such as the Godavari, Mahanadi, Krishna, Kaveri, that rise in the west and flow into the Bay of Bengal. You can see Bay of Bengal here. Okay, Bay of Bengal. यहाँ से rivers जो भी originate होती हैं, they come and meet the Bay of Bengal in the east. And this is because the Deccan Plateau, इसका जो slope है, वो west to east है. Okay, that is why the rivers flow in this direction. नर्मदा और तापी केवल ऐसी दो नदियां हैं दैट फ्लो फ्रॉम ईस्ट टू वेस्ट इनटू द अरेबियन सी. वो जाके अरेबियन सी में मिलती हैं. एंड सो मेनी डैम्स हैव बीन बिल्ट ऑन द रिवर्स टू स्टोर वाटर. दीज डैम्स हेल्प इन द इरिगेशन इन दीज एरियाज एंड ऑल्सो प्रोवाइड द इरिगेशन फैसिलिटीज. ओके, एंड देर आर सो मेनी वाटरफॉल्स ऑल्सो इन दिस रीजन. नंबर ऑफ वाटरफॉल्स आर देयर बिकॉज दिस रीजन इज फुल ऑफ द हिल रेंजेस. And one of the highest waterfalls in India, that is the Jo Falls, that is also located on the river Shravati in Karnataka, falls in this region only. Now, when we talk about the climate and the different soils found for the cultivation in this area, basically the climate in this plateau region varies from one place to another. एक जगह से दूसरी जगह का जो climate है वो बहुत ही different है. And the soil here is mostly black and red in color. Or black soil jo hota hai, that is very good for cultivation of cotton and the oil seeds. Groundnut, rice, sugarcane, wheat, millets, is tarah ke bahut sare crops jo hain wo grow kiye jate hain in the central region. And most of the people in the plateau region are farmers. Okay, the Western Ghats, you can see, when you'll see the greenery here, the Western Ghats and the Eastern Ghats, they are the northeastern Ghats especially, they have the thick forest. Okay, bahut hi thick forest yahan hota hai. And then the forest also provide valuable products such as the different kinds of wood, fruits, medicines. Okay, so many things we can get from the forest. And there are large coffee, tea, paper and rubber plantations. Kyunki yahan pe Nilgiri hills hain aur bhi dusre hill ranges hain, to unke slopes pe plantation crops grow kiye jate hain. And so many factories have also come up in this plateau region because they are the storehouse of minerals. Ye jo chota Nagpur plateau region hai hamara, this is the storehouse of the minerals, and they provide different minerals such as iron ore, coal, copper, mica. Okay, so these are very much populated also and very much important also for the different parts of the country and for different occupations and professions. And so many important cities are located in this region, like the Hyderabad, Nagpur, Bhopal, Indore, Bengaluru, Mysore. They all are the important cities of this region. Okay, so that's all with the plateau. So we are done with the plateau region now, and in the next video we will discuss the desert areas. Okay, thank you.